Hi everyone, and welcome or welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Priya Mistry, and I'm a general dentist with a practice dedicated to taking care of patients with TMJ disorders. Today's video is for dental practitioners, and it is a video of how I do our range of motion and muscle palpation exam at our office. It's an integral part of the initial patient evaluation and an integral part of diagnosing exactly what's going on. So for the muscle palpation and range of motion exam, I will be filming it and doing a voiceover so I don't have to really explain it with a mask on. I end up sounding pretty muffled when I do that. So here you guys go and enjoy. Hey everyone, we are back. All right, so I like to use this scale by Great Lakes for my range of motion exam. I tell the patients I'll be placing this little notch on their bottom front tooth and I ask them to open comfortably wide. I don't want them to hurt themselves. I'll be posting normal range of motion measurements in the description. Alex opened to about 50 millimeters, which is great. We turn it on its side, have the patient close halfway, and then shift the jaw over to the right and then the left. Then we get started with the palpation exam. I'm telling her to let me know if she feels anything more than pressure. And if she does, we'll grade it on a scale of 1 to 3. 1 is a little tender, 3 painful, 2 in between. We start at the anterior temporalis, those fibers, with 3 to 5 pounds of pressure, which is consistent throughout the exam. Walking slowly back through the middle and posterior fibers. Then we go over the preauricular area, which is basically the joints themselves, down the masseters, and then we go behind the angle of the jaw, which is where the posterior digastrics are. And then we go to the anterior digastrics and then down the sternocleidomastoid. These muscles can be pretty tender too. Then we go up the sides of the neck. So we're at the paravertebral area on both sides. And then I brace the forehead and check the suboccipital muscles. So my fingers are just running across the occipital bone. So I'm trying to show you where I am with that image there. And then I tell the patient we're going to be working inside the mouth. So I sneak my little finger way back there up into the superior posterior most soft tissue pocket I can find, and that's the lateral pterygoid. Then we go into the deep masseter and I brace the cheek from the other side, and then I run my finger along the anterior border of the ramus all the way up, and that's the temporalis tendon insertion. That's the cornoid process where that attaches. Same thing, other side. So I'm getting the lateral pterygoid here, and you can see she's halfway closed to allow me better access way back there. And with my outside hand, I'm going to show you guys where my inside finger is. So it's right about there. It's pretty far back in the mouth. And this muscle usually gets their attention as well. It's usually pretty hot. Then we check the deep masseter by bracing from the outside, and then we run our finger up the anterior border of the ramus to the temporalis tendon insertion. And that, my friends, was a muscle palpation and range of motion exam. I hope you guys learned something. If you liked what you saw, click like below, subscribe to my channel. If you guys have any questions or comments or things were unclear, please reach out. I'm so happy to answer them. It's hard to demonstrate these things on video, but I did the best that I could. And I hope to see you guys all again. Thank you.